Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the topic that is isotonic solution. The topic of and pH buffer and isotonic solutions. In that already we have to see the pH and buffer, and in the part 3 today's discussion we have to discuss about the isotonic solution or buffer isotonic solution. So in that isotonic solutions, some introduction part that we have to see that when two solutions have a same osmotic pressure, that we have to say that two solutions are there having the same osmotic pressure and salt concentrations, then we have to say that these solutions are isotonic solutions. The term that's used, iso means same, tonic means the concentration, same concentrations of the solutes are there, salt forms are there, and same osmotic pressures are there. So we can call that is an isotonic solution. So in that, in the physiological part, we can say that there are many situations in which we can say that the cell membrane becomes turgid, flaccid, or it remains normal. So that that according to the availability of that water into that particular cell that have faced the environment, three types of that environment we can say that in the solution form, isotonic terminologies are there, hypotonic and hypertonic type of solution. So in that we can say that the cell loves to be in isotonic state, and when some things that happen, changes may be happen that make it unequal, that can we can say that the if like hypotonic or hypertonic conditions are formed, so a cell becomes abnormal. So in that we can use the terminology the osmosis. So the movement of water molecules that across the semi-permeable membrane from region of, we can say that the lower solute concentration to higher solute concentration. So that process we can call as known as a osmosis. And the pressure that applied to prevent this movement, so that pressure we can call the osmotic pressure. In that terminologies are there osmolality, osmolarity. So that is a osmolarity is the concentration of osmotic solution. So we can measure in osmolarity the measure of solute concentration per unit volume of that solvent. So it is the number of osmoles of solute in a liter of solutions that we can call. So another terminology is isoosmotic solutions. Are the solutions then having the same osmotic pressure as the biological fluid like in blood? So we can call as a isoosmotic. So the conditions are there. So all the isoosmotic solutions are not necessary that having a or called as a isotonic solution. Second, the paratonic solution. So solution with differ the osmotic pressures are there. So we can call that the paratonic solution. So now the buffer isotonic solution. So in that we can call in pharmaceutical preparation, pharmaceutical solution suppose, so that we have to use for the applications. At that time it is affect into the delicate membrane of that body like tissue cell, specifically for the ophthalmic, we can call as ophthalmic part, ophthalmic delivery system to the eye. And second, the parenteral route, parenteral administration. So that time should have same osmotic pressure as that of that body part. So buffer isotonic solutions are the solutions that which possess biocompatible pH along with the osmotic pressure as that of that body fluid. So similar like that, that isotonic solutions have a same pH along with same osmotic pressure as the body part or body fluid like blood or lacrimal fluid. So buffer isotonic solution or fluids that do not affect that delicate part of, we can already say that the delicate membrane of that body part or tissue, or we can say that do not cause the swelling or the contractions of that tissue, or do not produce discomfort when that injected into that eye, the nasal tract, or the parenteral route, like into blood or other body part or tissue. So that is the isotonic solutions. So we can say that either physiologically isotonic solutions are the solutions having the same osmotic pressure as that of that fluid that across the semi-permeable membrane or biological membrane which, when they are separated by that membrane. So that biological fluids, including the example for that biological fluids like blood and lacrimal fluids, they are normally having a osmotic pressure that corresponding to that 0.9% weight by volume of that sodium chloride. So generally used for the isotonicity maintain that we have to use 0.9% NaCl solution. So that 0.9% solution of that NaCl that we can say to be isotonic with the physiological fluid. So isotonicity, already we have to say that the definition that solution having same osmotic pressure across the semi-permeable membrane. So defined as the solutions which maintain the isotonicity and the pH as that of that body fluid. So isotonic solutions that refer to the solutions that having the same osmotic pressure across semi-permeable, so that maintains the state that allows the for the free movement of water that across the membrane that without changing the concentration of solid on the other side. So that is the isotonic solution. So in that we can go for 0.9% weight by volume solution NaCl has essentially the same concentration and osmotic pressure as the RBC contained. So thus it is said to be isotonic with blood, and also we can call as a physiological saline solution or normal saline solution that 0.9% weight by volume solution. So if the RBC that we are suspended in 0.9% solution of NaCl, so that undergoes no changes in their size and shape of the RBC due to the isotonicity, because the same concentration and osmotic pressure in the RBC is match or similar with the 0.9% solution of NaCl. 0.9% means 0.9 gram NaCl in 100 ml of water solute part. So if our solutions containing 0.9% of sodium chloride is practically, you can say that is isotonic with blood, plasma blood, and is regarded as a standard on 0.9% NaCl solution. So in that, practically you can say that a solution containing more than 0.9% NaCl, so you can call it a hypertonic, and a solution containing less than 0.9% sodium chloride is called as a hypotonic solution. So here we can go for it, hypertonic solutions, we can say that defined as is one that has a greater concentration of solute than the reference solution, or you can case as a RBC contents are there. So it is a where the concentration of solute is greater outside the cell than the inside. Or you can also say this, the hypertonic solution has a greater osmotic pressures than the means outside than the inside, or that compare with the reference solution. So if examples is given, if we can go for RBC are suspended in 2% weight by volume NaCl solution, means hypertonic solutions, so then what happens? So that water that present within the RBC will come out. So it leads to cell shrinkage. So exit of water from the RBC that cause their shrinkage, and that becomes wrinkle in the shape. So that damage the RBC, the shrinkle of the RBC is known as a plasmolysis. Then second, that is hypotonic solution. So it is referred as that one that has a lower concentration of the solute than the reference solutions, or you can say the greater inside the cell, the concentration of solute greater in inside as compared to outside, or lower the osmotic pressure than the reference solution. So here the example, if we have to go for the RBC as suspended in 0.2% water volume solution of NaCl, the hypotonic solution. So then water from this solution will enter into the RBC cell. In hypertonic, water come out from inside to outside, and here the water from outside that go into the enter into the inner cell in the RBC cell. So that due to the osmosis, so due to the dilute the fluid within the RBC, that causing their swelling of that cell RBC, which may later result in rupturing of that RBCs and that release of hemoglobin. So that this rupturing of that RBC process, that is called the hemolysis. So two are there, hypertonic or hypotonic solutions are there. So from that we can say that tonicity is an important characteristic of that solutions, at which represent whether the solution has the same, less or more osmotic pressure than that of that biological fluid. Now next, the general principles we can say that for the adjustment of isotonicity. So where we have to require, why we have to adjust that isotonicity? We have to know that it is important to maintain the tonicity or isotonicity as similar like the body parts, body fluids, same we have to maintain the osmotic pressure for that solution part. So in that, mostly required for the parenteral preparation, that should be isotonic with blood, plasma. So that depending on the route of administration, so IV route, that require always, that require the isotonicity. Similar like subcutaneous, they not require intramuscular, that require hypertonic. So like that things are there for the parenteral administration. Similar like parenteral, other nasal and ophthalmic, both the case it should be require isotonicity, or we have to maintain isotonicity with the that body parts like nasal, the eye and the blood. So tonicity and the measurement of the tonicity, so we can say that it is the concentrations of only the solute that cannot cross the membrane, since the solute exert an osmotic pressure on that membrane. So the measurement of tonicity that may be determined by the following two methods are there. We can go for any one like hemolytic method and the colligative method. So colligative properties like freezing point, sodium chloride equivalent, molecular concentration, so temperature change base. So that is, if it is difficult to find out the osmotic pressure, we have to measure it. So we have to go for use of the colligative properties for the adjustment or determine the isotonicity part. So here for that for adjustment of tonicity, so here they are given the class 1 and class 2 method. In class 1, so in that the sodium chloride that we have to use to add it to the drug solution to reduce or to make the isotonic with the body fluid. So here in that they classified the cryoscopic method and sodium chloride equivalent methods are there. In class 2, so in this method water is added to the drug in a sufficient amount to form the isotonic solutions. So in that the White-Vincent methods are there in class 2 and Sproul's methods are there. So class 1 and class 2 methods are there for adjusting the tonicity. So we have to see one by one. So in the hemolytic method, so previous one here, the hemolytic method, so what happened in that? So in this method, so different drug solutions we have to prepare it, and then we have to go for observe the effect of that solution on the RBC cell, red blood cell, that appearance when they are suspended in that solution. So Hematocrit is used for this purpose. So in that we have to say that one capillary tube we have to take, and that we have to fill with the blood and diluted with the 5 ml of 0.9% weight by volume of NaCl. So that is isotonic solution that we have to put into the one capillary tube. And then we have to take another capillary tube that is filled with the blood and then diluted with the our test solution. Previous one we have to take the standard solution, that is 0.9% weight by volume NaCl solution. In second tube, capillary tube, we have to take 5 ml of test solution. Both the tube we have to go for centrifugations with high speed. Then we have to take packed cell volume of the test solutions, the tube B, and that we have to compare with the standard isotonic solution tube. If the test solution, the B that we have to take our test solution is same as that of the tube A, means our standard, so we can say that it is a isotonic. If the RBC volume of the tube B is more than that of the tube A, so that is we can call the solutions become a hypotonic solutions are there. And if the RBC volume of tube B is less than that the RBC volume of tube A, so that is we can call as a hypertonic solution. In hypertonic solution that release the oxyhemoglobin, that is directly proportional to the number of cell, that is go for hemolyze. Second properties are there, colligative properties. So in that colligative properties that determine the solutions, that method is used based on the measurement of slight difference in the temperature from the difference in the vapor pressure of that the thermally insulated samples are there, the freezing point method that we have to use based on the we have to use the colligative properties like sodium chloride equivalent, freezing point data, molecular concentrations are there. So that we have to, now we have to go for one by one for method for adjusting the tonicity, or we can say the as well as the pH base. So the method that is based on the freezing point, depression method or cryoscopic methods are there. So in that the physical, the properties of the solution that we can call, that is the freezing point, depression, that is the colligative properties, the temperature that we have to go for it. So if the body fluids such as blood plasma and the lacrimal fluid, the tear fluids, they are having a freezing point of minus 0.5 to 52 degrees Celsius. So due to their different solid present in them. So now if 0.9% solution of NaCl, that is we can call isotonic solution, having a freezing point of similar like the freezing point of blood and the lacrimal fluid. So it is minus 0.52 degrees Celsius. So hence solution which freeze at that temperature will be isotonic with this fluid. So the adjustment of the tonicity of the solution, that is simplified if the freezing point of, we can say that 1% solution of that substance whose tonicity is to be adjusted, and the freezing point of that 1% solution of adjusting substance are known. So then the freezing point are usually expressed in term of 1% solution, which can be noted from the reference tables are there. So the calculations for the formula for that adjustment, amount of adjustment substance required, that is minus 0.52 minus A upon B. So the A represent, where A represent the freezing point of 1% solution of unadjusted solution, and B is the freezing point of 1% solution of adjusted substance. So from that we have to calculate the concentrations or the weight by volume of percentage of adjusting substance that we have to needed to maintain the isotonicity. Second, the method that is based on the molecular concentration. So the molecular concentration, the number of unit or the molecules of ion or both that present in the solution. So this here, this if 1 gram molecules, the solution containing 1 gram molecules of non-ionic solute, that is in 22.4 liter at normal temperature pressures, has an atmospheric pressure of that 1 atmospheres are there. So therefore, a solution containing 1 gram molecules in 1 liter will have an osmotic pressure of 22.4 atmospheres are there. So based on there also, based on the molecular concentrations also we can calculate their formula, like the weight by volume of substance that require is equal to 0.03% into gram of molecular weight. And if ionizing substance are there, so that 0.03% into gram of molecular weight divided by number of ions that is yielded by the molecules for the non-ionic substance and ionic substance, that is the formula for based on the molecular concentration. In that class 1, the third, the sodium chloride equivalent methods are there. So in that, the sodium chloride equivalent method is one of the most widely used, that is method in calculating the amount of sodium chloride that required to prepare the isotonic solution or isotonic drug solution. So sodium chloride equivalent, the E values of the drug, is the amount of sodium chloride that in gram we can say that is equivalent to the 1 gram of the drug. So that is the thing. E values are the, so E values of new drug can be calculated from that equation based on the freezing point depression. The LSO values are there. So E is equal to 17 LSO upon molecular weight, the M. So M is the molecular mass, and LISO, that is a freezing point depression of that drug solution. So from that calculation E value, we can find out the concentrations or the sodium chloride equivalent of that drug values. So that is the based on the sodium chloride equivalent methods are there in class 2. So based on the class 1, based on the sodium chloride, that we have to find out the concentration of sodium chloride and we have to adjust the tonicity. And in class 2, we have to add the water. Adding the water, and we have to maintain the tonicity. So that is class 2 method. So in that, first, that is White-Winsett method. So this is a class 2 method for calculating the tonicity, that involving the adding of the water to the drug to make isotonic solution. So this method involves the addition of water to given amount of drug to make isotonic solution, following by the addition of some other isotonic buffer solution or dilute vehicle to adjust the solution to up to the final volume. So here the volume of water that should be added in a given amount of drug to make isotonic solution, that is calculated by the formula, that is V is equal to W into E into 111.1, where V is our volume of isotonic solution that is prepared by the addition, the volume of water that we have to need to make the isotonic solution. W is the weight of the drug, E is the sodium chloride equivalent of the drug, the NaCl, and the 111.1 is the constant that denote the volume of isotonic solution in milliliters that is obtained by the 1 gram sodium chloride dissolved in the water. So that is the White-Winsett method. And the last method, that is Sproul's method. So this method is the simplification of the previous method, that is White-Winsett method. In that, here the weight of the drug is said to be constant value. In previous one, the weight of the drug, we can't go for the constant value. So here in that, we can go for the weight of the drug is said to be constant value of 0.3. So the equations will become from the White-Winsett, that V is equal to 0.3 into E into 3.1.1, so it becomes V is equal to 33.33 into E. So this is the different method to find out or to adjust the tonicity. So in that we have to discuss about the isotonicity, the hypertonic are there, what is the importance of to maintain the isotonicity, how we can measure the tonicity. So we have to go for two method, hemolytic method and colligative methods are there. Then method for adjusting the tonicity, so class 1 method and class 2 are there. Based on the in class 1 method, based on that, the addition of the sodium chloride into the solution, so that further classified two methods, the freezing point depression or cryoscopic method and sodium chloride equivalent methods are there. Class 2 method, that is based on the addition of water, and we have to adjust or make them to the isotonic solution. So in that, two methods are there for the classified: White-Winsett method and Sproul's methods are there. So thank you.